Hello, this is Clammy Games, and welcome to a first look at Spectrum, a minimalist freeform platformer by Venezuelan developer 3D Avenue, released on Steam in September 2016. For disclosure, I received a key for this game for free. In Spectrum, you play as a dark, three-eyed entity whose resting form is a ball, but this changes into the streak that you see in promotional materials when moving. The controls are really simple, making use of just the directional keys with WASD or the arrow keys. I call this a freeform platformer, as while your character is affected by gravity, continually mashing on the up key will enable you to hover or to move vertically, much like the controls in another indie freeform platformer in Phoenix Rage. The short-term goal is to complete the level by getting to the black portal at the end of the level. However, the game does layer on additional objectives, which I will talk about in a bit. The most striking thing about Spectrum to me is the visual look of the game. It has a graphical design that leans on the minimalist side of things, and this is especially evident in the menu and the interface. The levels themselves are also very nicely designed, with a very clean look to it, which belies the challenge and difficulty of the game. On the technical aspect of level design, the difficulty curve in this game is gradual, and it teaches you about the world through its levels rather than a drawn-out tutorial. There are also some interesting level designs, such as a level which continually rotates, auto-scrolling levels, and even one which I believe is inspired by Super Hexagon. So good stuff all around. One aspect which I like about this game is the use of colors. As a dark entity, one which is void of light, so to speak, your character actually takes damage when moving into colored surfaces. You start off with 3 points of health in each level, and touching a light colored surface causes 1 point of damage. The darker colored surfaces actually outright kill you and should therefore be avoided at all costs. Collectibles in this game are modes of light, and these do actually restore your health as well. As you can probably tell from the UI and the footage, this game is also on mobile platforms, and in typical mobile game fashion, there is the so-called 3 stars system for each individual level. Essentially, you are awarded the star equivalent for completing the following objectives on each level: complete the level under a par time, collect all modes of light, and finally, not taking any damage in the level. While there has been a lot of discussion about mobile ports coming to PC, in this instance, I do not actually feel like this is a problem, since it does increase the replayability of the levels as you strive to attain all 3 stars, much akin to trying to 100% a game. These 3 objectives presented are fairly challenging, especially in the later levels, and it does actually require a degree of mastery over the controls in the game. Spectrum also does something which I like in platformers, which is the feature of a dark world. Pressing tab in the level select screen allows you to switch between light and dark worlds, with the dark world levels being a more challenging variant of its light world equivalent. I really like the duality in this, as the designers are able to show you how tweaks can be made in levels to adjust the difficulty. Overall, my first impressions of Spectrum are really positive, since it has a stock art style and has fun but challenging gameplay. The level designs are really smart, and I had a good time playing through the first 25 levels or so, plus a couple of dark world levels here and there. Anyway, that will do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe, leave a comment if you like. Thanks again, and I will see you in the next video.